What's up, Nitro Nation? Muggy Maniac is in the cave, and theme of this video is Nitro Archeology. If you already haven't figured it out, obviously you read it in the title. Because the Muggy Maniac has become a Nitro Archaeologist. What is an archaeologist? Well, you guys remember Indiana Jones, man. That guy was he was on the hunt for some of the rarest, sought-after shit, you know, and as far as, you know, collectible stuff or whatever you want to call it. Whatever it is that he, you know, was looking for or whatever people, I think it was whatever people would pay him the most. He would go find that shit. I used to love to watch the Indiana Jones series. Gotta have my... fresh ground Starbucks. Space Needle, Seattle. My daughter, my youngest daughter, got this for me when she went on a trip. First road trip with her friends. Man, I was so nervous. You know, those are my babies, man. My daughters, I don't know. I'm just overprotective. That's what dads do. Like I told a guy when he first dated my older daughter, listen, pal, okay, let me tell you something right here. All right, my daughter better be back by this time. If not, I got a 45 and a shovel, and nobody will miss you. Trust me. Got it? He was like, yes, sir. Yes, sir, Mr. Hernandez. All right, don't be messing around with my daughters, because... he gets some serious ass whooping. But anyway, welcome all newbies, middies, oldie book goodies, Truggy Maniacs. Muggy Maniac. We got Project Muggy going on over here. We got one thing I'm waiting on for here. I think I told you guys. We have the modded Pico .28 P3. 7-porter. Badass. Nasty ass. Bam. Gonna get her mounted in there, but we are gonna put a center diff for the first time inside of my XTM Muggy. And you're like, how are you gonna do that, Muggy? Did you find one of the XTM ones? Cause they make them. Nope. I have this one here. It's got 100K in it. I think it's got 100K or 80K. I think it's 100K. This is an extra one that I got with my Techno. Now I already checked with the diff towers and everything in here. This will fit in here. The only problem is I don't have extra brake pads, because you got to use the Techno brake disc, the disc, Techno disc brakes to go around this. What I do with them? Where are my disc brakes? Around here somewhere. Oh, they're in here. I'm sorry. These, here's what they look like. So I ordered a whole nother center diff assembly with the towers and the top piece, new brake, and I need to get new brake shoes on here anyway, because these are getting kind of worn. So, I mean, I got the whole thing. It was like $25 for the whole thing. Shoe, new brake shoes, whole new assembly, new disc. So I'm going to use the old discs on here and put the brand new ones in the Techno. That way this will work, because I got to have brakes to stop, in the XTM. So the XTM will have the rear... diff. Oh, by the way, these have avid bearings. I forgot I even had avid bearings. There's so many bearings out there. I just go by, it doesn't matter who makes them, avid, Boca. Bocas are expensive. Hey, if it's an Italian or a Swiss or a German, or actually if it's a German or Swiss bearing, those are the best. I rode skateboards for many, 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 many years. It's another thing that you guys probably don't know about me, and I don't think I ever shared that. Back Tony Hawk, Lance Mountain, Pal Peralta, Tony Alva, those of you guys that even know who those guys are, legends. If you guys are even newbies, you know these guys are legends. Some of them still ride, too. Caballero, Christian Lasoy. I used to ride when those guys were, like, in their prime, and you know, pro skating. And Swiss and German bearings are the best engineering, again. Got to give it to the Germans and Swiss and the Europeans on their engineering, man. When it comes to bearings and shit, they know their shit. So if it's a German racing bearing, man, I don't give a damn who makes it. That shit's badass. you know, like I said, bocas are expensive, but I don't even know who makes bocas. These avids are pretty good. These are like mid-level, decent, last a long time. These are the avids that came in. They came in the Techno. The Techno was all set up with all avid bearings, which are pretty good bearings, and I've still used some of them. Some of them I kind of retired. I mean, they're okay. But anyway, this is going to go, I don't even know the teeth on here, inside the muggy. Okay, so that's what's going on with the muggy. It's going to get a center diff as soon as that part gets here, probably sometime next week. But we're not running that anytime soon anyway. The XCM muggies and the Pico are resting. They're taking a nappy. Nappy time. And also, 28.8 modded. Bam! Oh yeah. This one, there's the signature. Modded by RB Mods. Bam! Brick. Modded by RB Mods. Brick. Bam! This one's taking a siesta too. You know, it's kind of trying, it's basically keeping the company because everybody's in vehicles right now. Because, you know, this is the lonely one. It did have a, you know, a shelf partner, which was the LRP .32, but then I decided to take the LRP .32, do it the little MM muggy mod, and, you know, and then put it in my whips and run it. So it's never ran. This will be the biggest motor, not the baddest. I still think the Nova is the baddest that I have so far, as far as power-wise and quality for sure. But this LRP .32, I'm really curious of what it's going to do in this thing. So we're going to get this thing going this weekend. I'm going to try to get this thing. I got to get this thing back together. You guys know how I am. I'm not running shit until this Techno is completely back together and ready to rock and roll. Because I'm not going to bring another dirty vehicle back from the field, as I call it, dirty, and have this one still not even finished and put together. Okay, that's not how I roll. I used to do that, and then it was I had to look at all my vehicles are dirty because I just want to run them, and then now I got to clean them all. Man, that's just too much for me. Trust me, I can be lazy with the best of them, but I know in this game, if you want to be on top of your game, if you want to bring your A game, you need to be on top of your shit. You need to stay ahead of the curve, you know, keep your shit up, take care of it, maintain it, check it, inspect it, or you better, like that Ice Cube song, you better check yourself before you wreck yourself. You better check your shit before you wreck your shit. How's that? Little muggy, little, my bad version of rapping. But anyway, we got some serious unboxing. I already started, man. It's like Christmas, man. This shit just built up. It's like, not all here. I was going to wait till the rest of it got here next week. But I'm like, you know what? Excuse my language. I was like, fuck it. You know what? Let me give my viewers show them what's going on, how I acquired this shit, give you some tips on what I look for, the do's and don'ts, you know, and just how I go about being an archeologist of nitro. Over 4 years experience on these laptops, computers, hunting, searching, looking, bidding, making offers, getting declined on offers, getting turned down, getting shit shipped that wasn't supposed to be shipped, getting shit shipped that was damaged or package was damaged, sending it back, you owe me this money, blah, 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 this, shitty review, I mean, all that, all the eBay things. Amazon, I don't like to deal with too much. But I do tell you one thing about Amazon. Man, when they say that shit's going to be there, it's going to be there on time, on point. Doesn't matter if it was snowing or tornado, your shit's going to be there with their Amazon. But the bad side about Amazon is they don't tell you anything on it. If you go on Amazon and look for something, you can't pull up all the information on it. The specs, the measurements, you know, what condition, if it's something. And they don't sell a lot of used stuff on Amazon anyway. It's all brand new. eBay is where you get a lot of the deals. But you got to deal with the headaches, man. PayPal sometimes isn't on point. That shit gets messed up. Somebody ships your shit wrong. These guys want to charge you $40 for a product, for a part that you're paying $20 for. I mean, these people are out their ass. Some people think that there's that. I mean, there is. But there's not that many stupid people out there. There is. And if you're that person, shame on you by getting, excuse my language, getting it up the rear end by these guys out there. And that's what I want to do this video for. I did one back a while back, and I got, like, more views than any video I've ever done. Okay, although that one that I did at the end of the Dynasty about Team Losi, that one I've got a lot of views on it. You know, and that was just like stating the facts that the Losi is no longer Losi anymore. It hasn't been. Come on, people. When that would be like if Dale Earnhardt, in the middle of his career, prime of his career, Chevy fucked him over, excuse my language, or GM, or Goodrich, whoever his sponsor was, and he left. Do you think that Chevy's would have sold, or that company that sponsored him would have sold as much shit? Well, some people would have stuck with the company, but I don't know why. I'm out. I'm gone. Oh, this guy, the legend, he's no longer with Chevy? Oh, yeah, where's he going? Ford? Okay, I'm driving Ford. If he says that Fords are good, you know, and I granted these guys get paid to say whatever, but I don't think that's, in all honesty, really a fact. Adam Drake didn't just go to Mugen because they're paying him so much money. Adam Drake went to Mugen because he knew their quality. Adam Drake's not a guy that's just going to settle for, yeah, let me go to S-Works, or let me go to Agama, or let me go to, you know, whatever. I mean, actually, he upgraded. He didn't downgrade, in my opinion, and his opinion, too. He went from Team Losi, man, they don't want to. He seen the direction that they were going, and he didn't want to go that direction with Horizon. He's like, hell no. I've sent him emails, and you probably have heard your own stories, and I've talked to plenty of people that know Adam personally. They just kicked him in the balls and told him, you know what, we want to go more toward, we're not, you know, I know you want to race and develop, but we're not so concerned about that. Adam's like, what? That's what I do for a living. What do you mean? Well, you know, we just want to worry about the sales. Adam's like, yeah, I know, I understand that. That's cool and everything. But if we're not going to race and develop and try to be the top dogs, well then, I'm out. And they said, well, don't let the door hit your ass on the way out. And that just disrespected my boy, man, like I said before. How do you do that to a legend? Again, Dale Earnhardt, if Chevy told him that in the middle of his career, do you think Dale wouldn't have put up with that shit? He would have said, peace, I'm out too. And that would have been the end of Chevy. I wouldn't even consider Chevy anymore. If you're a Dale Earnhardt fan or a Chevy guy, let me ask you, Chevy guys, honestly, if Dale Earnhardt, middle prime of his career, got screwed over by Chevy, would you even consider Chevy's? Some of you would say, yeah, because you know it's Chevy's quality anyway. But some of you would be like, man, I don't know, maybe not. But we're not talking cars, man. We're talking a hobby. Listen, Adam said, Austin the TLR, they just went downhill, and the rest is history. So anyway, that was, you know, when I did that video, I was just trying to keep it as honest and real as I can. You know, Adam is a great guy, man, and that guy deserves the utmost respect 24/7. He does videos when he doesn't even need to. He puts up a video once a week consistently, man. Who does that? You tell me what pro at his level or his status, a legendary status, does videos like that. I'll tell you how many. Zero. That's why I respect him even more. Man, and I can email him or I can text him and he'll try to help me out on shit. He's always answering. Man, that guy is a cool. Everybody that even knows him, Mayfield and Tessman and Angaro and Tebow and Cavallari and all these other pros, man, they respect that guy. That guy is the godfather to them. That's their dad. That's Pops. He's not that old yet. That's why when he did the engine braking thing, man, all those guys that I just mentioned, those are the top 10 guys in the world of nitro racing. They get their motors broken in through Adam because they trust he knows what he's doing, man. Ty Tessman even said, world champion, youngster. He said, man, Adam knows his shit, man. Why do you think I send my motors to him? I don't like breaking them in. None of us racers like breaking in. That's the worst part of it. And I don't think it's for me anyway. And I know it does take time. I think it's exciting to me. But maybe I can get what they're saying. You know, they want to race the shit. That's what they get paid for. I don't got time to break in shit. So now when Adam does the break-in bath thing, man, they get their motor. It's good to go. A couple braps around the track, tank, and they're ready to just, they're ready to just pin the throttle and get busy. And they trust Adam to do that because of who he is. So anyway, that video that I did there, I got like 500 reviews. I've never got that. I mean, I think I've got more than that at one other one. But anyway, the shipping one. Because people don't even know what the hell they're doing, man. I see people get motors and pipes shipped and shit like this. And look, see that hole right there? Yeah, you know what came in that package? Here, I'll show you. I'll show you what came in that package. A freaking $40 piece of Italian jewelry right here, people. Look at that. Bam. Does that say China to you? That's me. That's Italy. Don't get that twisted, all right? You know how the Muggy Maniac is. I'm just Italian, man. I got Italians in my family, by the way. You know, I love Italian food. I love everything about Italians, man. I had one guy said, "Are you Italian?" He thought I was Italian. I'm like, no, but I love Italians, man. They just make quality, man. This ain't no China, man. This ain't no OS. This ain't no, you know, I have OS. I have Osna Motors. But this is Italian, man. This is not rice burner. Okay? If you like rice burner and that works for you, great. But until you try an Italian and you don't own an Italian, shut the fuck up because you don't, excuse my language, you have no idea. I'm telling you, man, these guys out there that have never run Italian motors or Italian pipes, just Italian motors alone, get the Novarossi 28.8 fast as you can. Save your money, work more hours, work overtime, do what you got to do. I got two more of them coming, okay? And then I'm good. I'll have four 28.8s. Elite RC told me not too long ago, or when I talked to him, he's like, dude, how many 28.8 Rex Legends do you need? I said, how many can you need? Or what did he say? He said, how many do you have to have? Or how many do you need? I said, not enough, bro. I want a case of those motors. If I can get my hands and I have the extra money, I would right now buy a dozen, a full case, or how many comes in a case? At least a dozen of brand new 28.8 Novarossi Rex Legends right now. That's how much I love that motor. That's why I talk highly about it, because it's the total package, people. Stock, modded, doesn't matter. Buggy, truggy, wherever you want to put it, man, this thing's going to rock. Baddest carburetor on the planet, period, end of story. There is not a carburetor out there on the market that tunes, holds a tune, stays tuned, takes a beating like this. This is the package, people. This is it. You don't have to spend 100 and whatever to get it modded. Buy it for $190 and keep it stock. You want to spend $300 on an OS? I won't even spend $300 on a Reds motor, and I love both of those. And I love Reds, and it's Italian. But it's a .21. You're going to spend $300 on a .21, and that does it for you, then that's fine. But I'm telling you, once you own one of these, get it dialed, tuned in, run the 2 gallons. Even when you get them and run them for a while, you're going to be, like, amazed. Let alone when you get it to 2 gallons, this thing just comes to life. It's a whole nother motor. This thing's not there yet. It's only a quart away, man. It's getting there. It's just when you run it, it gets stronger every time. When I ran this thing, just like with my stock one, every time I ran that thing, man, it just got badder and badder. It's weird. All Italian, most Italian motors are like that, but I noticed more than Novarossi. So get that motor. Once you get that motor, you won't mess with China Man anymore. You won't mess with the OS Drake on OS Speed. You know, you won't even be messing with, the only reason you're messing with this thing is because it's bigger. That's it. You know? So that's why, man, and it's Italian. That's the biggest thing, man. I don't know what to tell you guys. I feel like a broken record sometimes, man. You want to... If you've never driven a Ferrari, I guess you don't know what it's like. And that's in the sense of if you never owned an Italian motor, Pico, Works, Novarossi, Reds, those are the Italian motors out there that are the quality ones. You know, I mean, that Pico P3, shout out to Mr. Whipke, my brother from another mother, you know. He got me on, I couldn't find him anymore, and he's like, yeah, I talked to the guy that had them on eBay, and he said he's getting more made and getting them, so he'll have them coming up in the next couple weeks or whatever. And as soon as they hit the eBay again, man, I might grab a couple of them. I love that Pico, man, and that motor's $135 shipped to your door. But keep in mind, you're going to have to spend 10 or 12 bucks on the plug. And I suggest a plug, use this plug. This is another plug. We're going to do some unboxings. I've already done some unboxings, but right here, people, bam. I just got this in. LRP, there's the part number, 35051. These are the ones that was recommended by Mr. Zai. Because I asked him about it, he's like, man, run these non-turbo plugs in any motor that doesn't have a turbo head. which is the LRP.32 and the Pico P3.28. Those are non-turbo heads. Why? I don't know why those guys. I mean, Pico has turbo plug motors, but I don't know why. And they don't even give you a damn plug. That's the only thing that pisses me off about Pico. I think I sent them an email. Well, you guys are charging, you know, some of their motor, high-end motors, too. I mean, I didn't complain too much because it's, a, you know, that motor was only 130-something bucks. But then it came out to almost 150 because I got to buy a plug for it. There you go. That's the plug. A-Main. All day long. A-Main. I love A-Main, man. They ship your shit, like, prompt. I'm trying this. Just got this in. I've already opened up a few things. Man, I couldn't wait. You guys know how I am. But I did open this up. But the main package to that I'm going to share with you guys is right here, man. You're going to see, and I'm going to tell you, show you, explain how I got this, what you look for. And just, you know, I'm trying to help people out that don't have a lot of money to spend in nitro, but want to have it, do it, enjoy it, have fun at it, and just, more importantly, lessen the headaches. The headaches is what's going to get you to quit, not want to do it, and just go do, excuse my language, fucking E-word, man, and I don't want that just as much as Mr. Zah. Mr. Zah and I agree on that. We do not want people coming into nitro getting discouraged because of maybe a little shipping shit like that. That would piss me off if I was new, you know, or because, you know, we can't get a plug for this for a certain motor, or you know, we can't get something tuned, or whatever. Some little, you know, petty shit, you know, we don't want that to make, you know, somebody to go to E-word, you know, screw that. But then again, if you're the guy that just doesn't want to get your hands dirty, you don't want to roll up your sleeves, you don't want to, you know, do some wrenching in here, you know, do some upkeep, some maintaining, you know, get your shit on point, then what do you want me to tell you? You know, there's an easier way? There isn't. You know the easier way is? Just do it and get it out of the way. Quit crying about it. I hear the guys complaining, crying. Oh, you got a wrench. Oh, I got my fingernails dirty. Oh, you know, it's a headache. And it's not a headache. You're just lazy. Excuse my language again. Lazy fucker. If you're lazy, have no patience, don't want to get your fingernails dirty, don't want a wrench, don't do nitro. Get out. Get the hell out. Go. Bye. See you. Unsubscribe to me. Don't view my shit. You know, get out of it. Go do E-work. Go knock yourself out until your lipos burn down your garage. Hopefully they don't, but they might. Or burn up your $400 Traxxas or whatever, melt it to the ground, or your Arma, melt your shit to the ground. Go for it, man. I'm good. You know, I'm all about nitro, man. That's it, man. I just got to get my, as long as I got my brap juice right here. By the way, this is the only shit that I use. I just got this in a box. Came in this box. Pretty cool. Now, people ask me about the Byron's fuel. They can't find it. Here you go. This company's got it all day long. It's only in the quartz, but it's pretty cheap. Force RC. Okay? Byron's 3011. This quart cost me, that was like $18 shipped to my door. I paid $21 at my hobby shop for a quart. That's why I just usually get gallons. It's $45 Byron's. So anyway, that's the fuel you want. If you want to just eliminate one less issue that you might have in tuning, there you go. Byron's 3011. Guys that run 25%, whatever, I run 30, man. Your motor gets way better performance. Ask Mr. Zod, does he run 25%? He'll say, for what? Breaking? Maybe. But for brapping my motors, stock or modded, 30% all the way, man. So you guys use whatever you want. What else did I get? Oh, so yeah, so we got the uranium, right? You know, made in China. Where else? Okay. Here you go. This is the real plug right here, piss. No. This is the Italian, baby. The Novorossi. C6TGF. Look at that. You can't even see it because it's black. That's a sick plug. Now, look at Novorossi makes all their shit. Look at that. See what that says, people? That says, you know what that says right there on the end? Can you read? Made in Italy, people. That's right. Muddy Maniac, I went through my headaches, man. I beat my head against the wall. I wanted to quit nitro a handful of times because I got pissed and, you know. But then when I switched and learned from Mr. Zog, you know, just spend the money on the motors, platforms, and the radios. And just quality, man, and you'll lessen your headaches. And ever since then, yeah, I don't have very many headaches anymore. It's pretty cool. I enjoy A-Scale Nitro a hell of a lot more now than I did 2 years ago because I was dealing with low-end shit. Offmas and OSs and, you know, I was, you know, dealing with cheaper radios and, you know, I mean, the Offna motor, it's a great motor, you know, but it's made in Taiwan. You know, Offna's Taiwan. I told a couple guys, and I thought of getting a Hyper 7 because it is, you know, part of Nitro. But those are collected. If you want to collect shit, then that's cool. If you want to run shit and run shit hard and good quality shit, then you need to look elsewhere. You need to look at Mugen. You need to look at Associate. You need to look at Techno. I would say look at T. Losi, but look at what? Look at them discontinue all their shit, you know? And we already went through that whole thing. Losi just, they're done. It's a done deal, man. It's a wrap. So if you're a Losi guy, I feel for you, man. I'm sorry. You know, they're going to discontinue. I guarantee you, watch, mark my words, they're going to discontinue some more of their shit. I think the next one coming is the 5T and the 5B. And I don't really care. They can discontinue all those fit scales. I'm just going to go with the, like, Elite. I recommended the King Motors. Makes the XT something 3. You know, it's like a $700-something, but it already has all the hop-ups, and it's a truck. It's a truggy, or a truck, whatever you want to call it. It's a truck. It's not a buggy. Would I like to get a Losi, you know, 5B? Yeah, but, you know, hey, I don't need to support Horizon anymore, you know. I already do by buying my TLR shit, buying my Dynamite shit, Hobbyco shit, which Horizon owns all them anyway. That's the only business that I'm going to give those companies. They're owned by Horizon. As far as the Losi and the TLR shit, yeah, I really don't care. Doesn't concern me anymore. And we also got the part that I've been waiting for. Man, this shit came quick, people. I just ordered this shit like Thursday. What's today? Saturday? This is what I needed. Diff pinion. This is my diff pinion. This is for the rear. Okay? Straight cut. CNC machine. Okay, now I don't replace techno stuff, so, you know, that's what I like about it. If you do replace techno stuff, yeah, it's affordable. Check out RC Waffle. They got a lot of new and used shit for technos, or if you have a techno and Mugens and other vehicles, for good price. I use RC Waffle a lot. But this is brand new. Techno, okay? Part, pinion. It was starting, the teeth on my other one were starting to wear. You know how much this was? $20. $20 for this little thing. But I'd rather spend the $20 on it now, get it fixed, than tear up my other gears in there. Then I'm messing with the bevel gears. Well, I think I have extra bevel gears. Or are those for, I don't know if I have. I think I have them for the Mugen. Yeah, I do have them for the Mugen. So anyway, let's see. What else? Oh, we got this here. RC Renew. This is Nitro Fuel Lubrication. So we'll see what kind of lubrication that Mr. Lance, owner over there at RC Renew. By the way, I've got a Triton 2148 pipe that's going to be coming soon from RC Renew. And I'm thinking of sending them a motor to see how his work is. I'm curious. He's the RC Renew, they're the technical version of Rick at RB. Rick is this old school. Great work. I have never had an issue with any of my motors. My Nova Rossi, RB modded. My Reds, R5 Team Edition, modded, RB mods. Badass 20.21. And my Pico. And I'm going to send Rick another 3. You know, Rick does good work. Just Lance is just next level. Like, whole next level. Dyno machines, the whole shit. So if you're one of those technical guys, you might want to look at RC Renew. I just need to try them and see how they are. You know, I would just send him all 3 motors. He would tell me he would do all 3 motors for $325. Rick charges me $300. It's $100 only if you give him more than one motor. One motor is $125. But if you have him mod more than one, it's $100 flat. This is the only stuff that you want to use mounting your tires. Medium, dynamite glue. There you go again. Look, Horizon. This is going to Horizon. I'm supporting them, even though it's dynamite. They own them. So, anyway. But this company, well, you know who owns this. A-Main. Adam Drake speaks highly of Protec, uses a lot of their shit. I gotta try Protec servos, man. They're just real pricey. But you want to get the quality, you want to get less in the headaches, spend the money. You know, I might just spend $200 on a couple Protec servos, you know, and just keep them on the side and, you know, I don't know, put them in something that maybe that I'm going to not run as much, or I don't know. I run all my shit. There is nothing in this room that is retiring anytime soon. Motors, maybe, but vehicles, nah. Anyway, these are the caps that go over your exhaust, fuel inlet to your carburetor, your idle needle, and your carburetor. So carburetor and exhaust. You want to keep your shit sealed. If you're not running your motor and it's out, bottom dead center, after run fluid in it, okay? And these caps. Don't get that messed up, okay? So those are the couple things that I opened so far. Because, you know, Muggy Maniac just couldn't wait. Like Christmas. But I saved the main enchilada right here, people. Let's get into this bad boy. Because we probably know what this is. Alright. Now this came from, I don't even know where this guy is. Cambridge, Illinois? It's got from Illinois. He sent a bunch of look at all the stamps. He kept one. USS Missouri, people. In the USA, people. That's what I'm talking about. Alright, what do we got here? What do we got? Oh, what? Is it sleeping? Is something taking a nap in my box? What is that? Is that an Italian piece of machinery in there? Is that a fine engineered Italian piece of machinery? Let's take a look at this bad boy. Oh, snaps. Happy to see me. Look at that. Happy to see me. And look at this. This motor is happy to see me. Mr. Zai would say, happy to see me. It's at attention. What's that say? Mr. What does the exhaust say? Mr. Tuned. That's cool. Look at that. The red's pipe. Mr. Tuned. It's a Mr. Tuned EFRA 2104. Bam. This is, man, all I could think about is when I buy motors, man, especially when this is used to me, or new to me, but used to you guys. This thing, from what the guy said, this doesn't even have it doesn't even have a gallon through it. This has less fuel through it than even my other one did. My other Reds that I got had a gallon through it. This one, the guy said he broke it in and it's got maybe a quart run through it. This thing is spanking new. He ran it a few times on the track, and that's it. I mean, it's brand new, man. Look at that, man. This is the Italian machinery I'm talking about. There's those new carburetors that Reds run now. Never had one of those. Interested to see how these go. See the high-end needle? It's on the side. Crazy, huh? It's a Mario design. But I know my old Reds carburetor, man. I don't know. I mean, Raja's, you know, he's doing the racing thing, and he said I think he has an air leak, but this is the Rex. They call them HCX carburetors. This is an R5R. It's not a team edition like my other one. This is a Reds R5R racer. Comes with the combo, pipe combo. And look at that. That's a Reds clutch bell, people. And a Reds... Spin that. Oh, yeah. Fresh batter, fresh bearings in that baby. Hell yeah. Alright, now let me tell you something about this motor, people. This motor, R5R, Red's motor, oops, is on I got my front end. I gotta put this techno together here as soon as I'm done with this video. This motor, you can go to A main. The motor and the pipe combo is like 300 and some change, brand new. By the way, let's see if we can one hand the clutch bell. Oh, hear that? Hear that, people? You hear that? Sounds like some compression in that sucker. Shit. This thing is just like, this thing's ready to get fired up. This thing's ready to get fired up right now. I'm ready to fire up this thing today. But we're not going to be firing up anytime soon, you know. We got bigger fish to fry than pea shooters right now. But it's a badass pea shooter, I'll tell you that. And I tell you, man, unless you own an Italian motor, even a pea shooter, you don't have no idea, man. Get all the alphas and OSs and even LRPs and, you know, all those companies that make the .21s. But until you own an Italian .21 or bigger, you have no idea what you're missing yet. There you go. By M. Rossi. You know who M. Rossi is? Mario Rossi. By the way, those of you who don't know anything, new subscribers, Mario Rossi is the son of the late, great Caesar Rossi, which was the founder of Nova Rossi Engines. He passed away a few years ago. His wife took over, and she's just running that company to the ground, sadly. Mario is no longer there. So the reason that I really like the Reds, even though they're only .21s, this is where Nova Rossi would have gone if Caesar was still alive. Mario couldn't get there because Mama Rossi, the mother running Nova Rossi, you know, she just wants to run the business. She's not concerned about technology, and she's just leaving it up to the people that work for her, kind of. You know what I mean? And when you got something like that, I mean, you're going to have issues because you don't have your hands in it or even know anything of what it's about. I mean, sure, she's been around it because of her husband and the family, but she doesn't know. She's never turned any wrenches on these things. She's a woman. And I'm not saying that, and I have daughters, so don't get it twisted. I'm not chauvinistic, but I mean, she's not a gearhead woman. You know what I mean? She's not like a Danica Patrick type girl. She's not a legendary Shirley Muldowney in drag racing, or even like John Force's daughters, you know, Brittany, Courtney, his daughters are badass. Those aren't regular girls, man. I mean, they're women, and they're fine, beautiful women. I've seen them. If you haven't, YouTube, John Force, his daughters, they're beating his ass in racing. You know, the apple does not fall far from the tree, trust me. But sometimes the apple falls and hits the tree, and they're giving him, they outrun his old man, their old man all the time. You know, those are his girls. He has all girls, man. But look who their dad is, man. The legend, legendary John Force, all-time winningest drag racer in the world ever. And his daughters, man, they're spanking his ass. But those are engine gearhead motor girls, man. And those, by the way, are sexy as ever. If I ever remarried, or God willing, I'd have to have one of them motorhead girls. Beautiful. I had a girlfriend one time like that. She was into wrenching, and you know, they're rare, but they're out there. I wish my daughters were like that. My daughters are beautiful. They're just not into wrenching. I can't even get them to hold a camera for me and my nitro. But anyway, Mario, this is what Mario wanted to do with Nova Rossi. These Reds, even though they're .21s, are a next level above Nova Rossi. Okay, you guys have seen my videos comparing them, taking them apart. There's just, these Nova Rossis are another level. I mean, I just wish Mario, and I've emailed them plenty of times, if Reds came out with a .28, even a .25 quality like this, oh, hell yeah, it'd be on and cracking, people. Can you imagine if Reds put out a .28.8? And he knows he has how to do it. His father put out, is the one that, and he probably helped him put out the .28 Rex Legends. But the Rex Legend, even though as great a motor as it is, and you guys know it's my favorite motor, it's the technology is just not there in it. It's just old school, solid, reliable, durable, and that's it. Okay? It's a high-end Chevy truck, which would be what? Like Mr. Zaha, an Escalade, or a Navigator, or whatever, or Denalis. The Denali is the high-end Chevy. It's not no regular Chevy GMC, people. Don't get that shit twisted. If you know anything about cars and Chevys, ask Mr. Zaha. His cousin or whoever, what's his call it, has one. I think John does too. Those Chevy Denalis, that's the cattle, that's the high-end Chevy. That's what this is. This Reds is a high-end Novorossi because Mario is, you know, he's the son of Caesar. His motors are designed after the Novorossis. It's basically Ricolte that. These Reds are a Novorossi-based motor. But the, you know what's funny is the blocks of these things are made by Pico. Pico makes Reds blocks. This whole block down here, this whole piece here, from here all the way down, this is made by Pico. This is all Pico. Ask Lance at RC Renew. He'll tell you. He used to work for Pico. He used to design their motors. I didn't know that until he told me. He goes, yeah. Who do you think makes Red's blocks? Pico does. That's why they're badass. He loves Picos, by the way, Lance. He's like, man, you need to send me that one of those P3s, man. I'll make that mother, like, just ballistic. I might. That might be the motor that I sent to him. If I get a hold, when those come back, another one of the P3s, I might send that to him and have him just do his shit to it and make that thing just a monster. Because he's experienced with Picos. But anyway, man, this whole setup, without the clutch bell and the clutch setup here, at A-Main, brand new, is $300 and some change. Okay, it's a more affordable red. It's not the high-end red. If you look underneath, if you can see the fins, there's no holes drilled in it for cooling. Okay, there is on the bottom, but that's the button head. Now, if you look at my other reds, my R5 Team Edition, look up at there. See that? All the fins are drilled. On the higher-end motors, they do that. Just lighter, better for cooling, the whole nine yards. This is an upper-level R Reds .21 R5. That Team Edition one, okay? This one is like a notch down. It's still badass. And then that clutch bell, that Red's clutch system, four-shoe clutch system, okay? I think it's four-shoe. Maybe it's three. I don't know. I haven't looked. Oh, maybe it's a three-shoe. Huh. But anyway, that clutch system in there, the Red's clutch system, those are like $50. This pinion bell, I think it's a Red's. Yep. It's a Red's. And how many tooth is that? It says 16. Is that a 16 tooth? That's crazy. I've never had a 16 tooth. I think that's what it says. Do you guys see that? Or am I seeing things? 16? There's no way. 16 on that? I gotta count the teeth. That's crazy. A 16? This thing must scream like a mother. This setup, the only way they put the 16 tooth on there is because of something of this. I know this style of pipe. This length, it's like, this is like a mid-level, mid-engine pipe. Maybe this is mid. The motors, .21s, as you know, scream their balls off. And the 16, that's where you're getting the bottom, mid, and top. This might have a total package, the way they set it up, this whole thing. But I don't even think that this comes with it. If it does, these clutches are like $50. But anyway, let's just say this is it's A-Main. The whole setup's like $350. I paid $125 for this whole setup. And this shit is brand new. I mean, what caught my eye is the head. That's the first sign. If you look at heads and they're beat the hell up and scratched up, well, you do what you want. I won't buy them. I pass them up. This head was so clean on it, that's what caught my attention. I'm like, let me check this out. And then when I seen it came with the pipe and the whole setup for $125, I mean, the guy wanted, I think he wanted like $175. And I just was going to say $100, but I didn't want to cut him too low. I don't want to insult him. And it was worth $125. The damn pipes, if you get these pipes by themselves, these pipes are $100. So I paid for the pipe, and I got a motor and a clutch with it. And this thing, man, it's got mad pinch. can't even turn it with one finger. Yeah. This thing, he said he only got like a couple quarts through it, so this has not even got a gallon on it yet. This thing's brand new, man. Look at the engineering, man. These Italians, I'm telling you. There's nothing like these things. Look, even look at the header, man. Look at the way they cut out the fins in it. The back part right there, it's all to lighten it. Lightweight. Diamond cut back plates. That's what comes on the Reds. So yeah, Muggy scored on this one. That's an archaeological find. $300 motor. Let's just say $300. $125. How can you beat that? It's brand new. I won't buy a motor that's got more than a gallon on it. That's just me. I see guys, oh, it's only got 5 gallons on it. Well, just chance there might be more issues with it, so I won't do that. What else do we got here? Let's open this goodie. What do we got? Oh, shit. We got an associated carbon clutches. So, $13, man, for two of these? Come on, trust me. You guys know how I am. I'm anal about all, and I'm spending my money, man. You got to give me my value. The Muggy Maniac, another thing about finding this shit, I'm looking for deals, man. They're not the only one selling clutch shoes. If somebody wants 20, because I've seen these same ones, $20, hell no, let me look around. Bam, here we go. Who is this company? Liquid RC, good company, man. $13 for both, too. Clutch shoes aren't cheap. You want quality. You can get cheap ones if you want, but whatever. Now, these aren't new. These are the ones I had before, but they're cleaned up, and I just put them in here because they're ready to go. They're all, remember, when you're mounting these things, make sure you scuff up the outer and the inner lips, and then clean all the shit off with alcohol, pad, or whatever. You want these things clean. These are ready to go. Now, the only thing missing, I can't do this with one hand. Let me, set that up there for you guys. Where the heck? Oh, there's my knife. See, I got a little knife action here. Bam! Happy to see you. A little stiletto here. Let's see what's in this one. Now, this one I know what it is, too. And this one I've been just having sugar, so. Muggy doesn't do a lot of unboxings. You guys watch my videos, even in the past, the ones that I erase, I'm not an unboxing guy, you know? But I figured I got all this shit. Let me show you guys what I got. Oh, snaps. 11. What is that? The infamous, famous Badlands. 1178, people. Bam. 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 Look at that. Oh, and I got another set coming, too. They're out there still, man. If you guys need any help finding them, let me know. Best tires for your truggy. If you don't have a truggy, don't worry about it. But when you get a truggy, well, you might want to worry about it. You know what? It looks like they changed the pattern. What the hell? That's weird. Let me check this out. Let me compare something, people. Because this doesn't look the same. Oh, no, it's the same. They're brand new. I'm looking at mine over here. So we're going to have one. I'm going to have like at least 6 pairs of these, man, mounted on DE racing rims. I might buy the Pro-Line rims, but no need to. I like DE, man. And they're way cheaper. You get all 4 of these DE racing rims. Here's a part number if you need it. People, DERPT4-8B. Black, white, yellow. Those are the colors that I use. But this is the bad boys you want. If you find these, don't sleep on these, people, because there's not many out there. They're out there still, but you got to hunt for them. You got to do the, you know, Muggy Maniac archaeological searching like I do. And I found them. And I found another pair. Shit, I wish I could buy a case of that. I'll buy a case of these damn things, too. A case of Badlands and a case of Novorossi 28.8s. Why not? How can you lose? Here's the other set right here. Bam! Best $60 you'll ever spend. So 60, 80, under $100. Yeah, to some people it is pricey, but trust me. These are the bad boys right here. And I'll do a video on how I mount them. Mr. Zod did one, an older one, so I'll just do an updated. Some of the things that I maybe did a little bit different that helped me out. You know, not that his way isn't good. He has a video on it. You can watch him, but I want to explain a little bit more. Okay, are we almost done? What else do we got here? I think we got something else. What's this? What the heck? Let me see. Hold on. What is in here? Oh, shit. Yep, this is what I needed. We're going 125K TLR oil. I only use TLR and Associateds, man. That's just it. As long as it's out there and I can find it, I'm not using no Traxxas garbage. I have in the past. Yeah, I just won't use that shit. This is the best shit, man, for me. Whatever works for you. You want to use whatever you want to use, use whatever you want to use. This is what, if you want this, TLR 5288. 100, trust me, this shit is hard to find. This was one of my hardest things. I've been searching for even another 100K is hard to come by now. If you guys have it and it's not Traxxas, get it. TLR and Associated 100K is hard because from 80, it jumps all the way up to like half a million, you know, for fit scale. There's 100K. I'm going to get me more 100K too. I want both still. I have some. I mean, I still have some 100K, but I've got not even enough to do. Well, no, I do. I've got enough to do all my vehicles with 100K again. One more shot. I've got 80K. I was thinking of doing 80K in my buggy just because, you know, 80K is a little bit more mellow as far as, and not mellow, I don't want to say, but it's just, these buggies with modded 21s and bigger motors, man, they're nasty, squirrely little freaking squirrels, man. They get all over the place, but they're fun, man. So 80K just, you know, makes it a little bit more, handles a little bit better, that's all. But see, I've got the 180, 60, so I'm going to do 60 in the front. This is brand new, I haven't opened. 60 in the front, 60 in the rear. And then we are going to go the 125K, bam, in the middle. We're going to make that, we're going to get this Techno and this Mugen hooking up like a tow truck. I want the shit just to hook. I mean, it already does. You've already seen these things like this be standing up all the time, freaking pulling the front ends up and shit. Well, maybe this will make it do backflips. Who needs to get air? I can get air without a ramp. When my shit just brop and flips over. Somebody said that. Hey, who needs a freaking ramp? One of my subscribers made a comment. Who needs a ramp, Muggy, when your shit is hooking up so crazy that it's doing backflips? So anyway, what do we got here? We got one more package, do I? What is this? Uh-oh. Won't come out, people. Come out. Ah. Bam. There you go, man. It's an Intigy cooler. Now, you can use coolers. Do what you want. Some people say, oh, well, it's just, you know, better chance of getting air leaks. Trust me. You unscrew the ends of these because they unscrew, and you Loctite them. Then you will have no chance of these things leaking. Now this one's red because we got a reds, and with the buggies usually in, you know, we're in the Gotamore mode. So we're, you know, and I run that body. I run a lot of red on this MBX5R Prospect. So, you know, I got a cooler. These aren't cheap. The Nova Rossi ones are the best. I haven't got one of those yet. I might just get one. But, man, $25 for one of these? These Intigies, I've used them before. They're pretty good. They're like $15, half the price. So anyway, that's that one. There was another package that I know that I just got that I wanted to open. It says it came. Maybe it did. I don't know. Let me see. It goes with another thing I have, so maybe it's maybe I missed it. Let's see. It's in here. I know it's by Techno. Oh, snaps. There we go, people. This is vital to a well-tuned machine. Too many guys I've seen, and I want to put this out there recently, guys running videos and, you know, we've got the tuning down pretty much for those of you. We'll continue to iterate tuning, okay? low end, top end needle, low end needle, idle, blah, blah, blah. Remember, everything I told you guys that's connected to that motor is very vital to that motor being tuned. You can have the baddest adjusted, perfect low end, perfect top end, perfect idle, and if your clutch is all over the place, you're wasting your time, man. Your shit ain't gonna tune and dial. You might think it is, it's not. I hear the slippage, I hear the no bottom end, you know, lots of top end, you know, I hear the tons of bottom end, no top end, thing one idle, thing quits every time, you know. I mean, and you guys know your videos, and it's not to me your videos, and you're not doing any, but I'm telling you, man, you guys need to do your clutch homework. Watch RC Nerd, the old one. He's got some new series out, and that shit's whack, man. I don't know, I can't even understand what the hell. I tried watching it, his clutch thing that he's doing now, RC Nerd, and I'm like, man, this gave me a headache. And I'm like, why do I want to watch this? Let me just go watch his old school one he has, and that's perfect. Whenever I kind of want to get, you know, brushed up on clutching. But I've got clutching down pretty good. My clutch shit hooks up. The only reason my shit's pulled the front end up, I mean, it is the motor, the pipe, other things, but it's that clutch, man. My clutches are hooking up. 4-shoe on the truggy, 3-shoe on the buggy, sometimes 4-shoe on the buggy. But here we go. Techno clutch spring and hardware. Damn, there you go. Now, some of these are colored, and you can go by the colors, green, light, blue, medium, whatever. This whole thing was only like $12. I mean, I've got collet, I've got shims, I've got the nut, I've got I've got the whole deal, man. You got all your hardware, man. I mean, Techno's not too bad. Some of the shit is going to get pricey, depending. But they make a lot of shit, man. So there we go. More Techno shit. That's what I need. We got the Techno. Got that Techno, whatchamacallit, all the springs there. And, bam, we got some more associated shoes. I got some more. The Intachi makes some good aluminum ones. King Heads makes good ones. Buku makes good ones. And Max Life. Those are the names that you want to look at as far as clutches. Clutch bells, I use a lot of Pro-Tech. Clutch bells, I like their clutch bells, very affordable, good price. Everybody's got clutch springs. Look for the kits like this, okay? This will not just, if you got a 4-shoe clutch, it's just not for Techno. You guys want, there's the part number, TKR5353. I think it was like $15 for all this, man. Look at that, you got shims, you got collet, which are, collets are gold, man. Don't lose those. And I've got all different size collets now. I remember when I had like one or two. It sucked because you couldn't, if your collet's messed up, you're not going to get your flywheel where you need it to be. And it maybe might be too short. It won't touch your pinion. Or it won't, you know, be able. I mean, there's so many variations to setting up your clutch and, you know, your shim. And, man, clutching is is probably really one of the most technical things in Nitro. There's just so much variations and so many things to it. And that's why it's important, man. If that thing ain't dialed, you ain't going to get no tune, man. You might get a sounding tune, but that thing ain't going to perform like it should. You're going to be like, where's my power? And I think that's what's happening to Lights Out. It's not that his motors don't have power. His motors aren't. Your motors, bro, ain't hooking up. And I got you that clutch coming, man. You need to spend the money or, I mean, whatever you got to do. If you got shitty clutches and your springs are worn out and your shoes are, man, your shit is not going to hook up. You can tune and dial and modify and everything, especially when you get into modified. That's where I had to step my game up in clutching, man, because I have modified badass Italian .21s and, you know, .28s and soon, you know, semi-modded .32s and soon to be modded max modded .32s and so on. I can't be fucking around with clutches not hooking up, or my shit's gonna scream and make a lot of noise and sound badass, but it's not gonna do anything. I think that's what's happening to Lights Out. His shit is performing. Those .21s he has are badass. They're just not hooking up. If you ain't hooking up, then who gives a fuck? What clutch shoes are you running? Those ones that I mentioned, that's what you want to run. Check your springs. How do I check my springs? You take the clutch bell off, and you put your finger in here, and you pull back on the clutch shoe, and you can feel the tension. Is it light? Is it medium? Or is it hard to pull? That's how I check my springs, because you're not always going to get clutch springs, or even the low C ones. The colors fade on them after a while. And then you don't know what color they are. It's all nitro is feel, sound, and sight, man. It's seeing, it's hearing, and it's feeling, man. I can't emphasize that enough. Get that shit down. Get in tune with your shit. Okay, so that's the Muggy Maniacs archaeology deal there. And, you know, we are definitely at an hour already. Exactly an hour. So anyway, that's my video. You guys seen my shit. I've got goodies. I gotta just put my goodies away now and shit that I need to install and use and try. And, you know, I got pipes coming. I got more shit coming. I got more motors coming. I'm still looking for my platform and I'm being patient. That's probably the last thing that I'll get, however long it takes, maybe towards the end of the year, just because I want to get what I know what to get. I didn't get these whips over here for the deals I got by being impatient. So let me ask you guys, and I'll leave you guys with this. You guys say you're nitro gearheads. I see your guys' killer shops. Your guys are, you know, doing your thing. Guys are spending money on whatever. But I see a lot of guys watching their videos where I can tell they say they have patience, but I beg to differ. How much patience do you have? You got to ask yourself that. Calm down. Relax. Chill, bro. Take a pill. If you don't have the patient tolerance for this and you get frustrated and you get pissed off, maybe you just don't have what it takes to do nitro. Okay? Relax. Take a breath. It's all right. The Muggy's here. I got your back. If you need help, have any questions, hit me up, man. That's what I'm here for. You know, I'm not here to toot my horn and say, oh, look all the good shit that I have, and look at I can afford this, and look at... Hey, I'm just keeping this shit real, man. If you want to lessen your headaches, spend the money. If you don't got the money, work harder. Get another job. Like John will always say, man, work some overtime. Don't give me excuses. You, unless you're crippled or can't, get out there and do what you got to do to make some more cheddar so you can get the quality shit. So you can get the Italian shit. So you can get the good stuff. And you don't have to settle for the bullshit. You know? I'm not going to sugarcoat it and say, ah, well, it's okay. You can get the cheap stuff. It's good for now. No. I will say, do what you got to do. And to have fun, you don't need to spend all the money. But keep in mind, when you don't and you settle for lower quality, you are going to have way more headaches, man, than you are already going to face in troubleshooting and the issues that you will have in nitro. So just lessen the headaches, okay? Do your homework. Do your studying. Watch some videos. Be patient, please. And just, you know, I don't want nobody going to no E-word shit. We want more nitro brothers in the nation. Just check your approach and what you're doing. Ask yourself, do I have the patience to hold out, to wait, to just, you know, settle down and don't jump the gun. And I know guys are, you know, like I said before, oh, I want to grab an Agama. That's such a good, because they're such in a hurry to get a new vehicle. You have vehicles, run what you got. Do what you got with what you got, you know, and just be patient. It'll come. Trust me. Been there, done that. That's all I can tell you this. I've been through all that. And man, I'm so glad that I'm able to, and I consider myself very blessed that I'm able to afford this and, you know, and be able to take care of all my responsibilities and still have time and still have the money to invest in the good shit, man. If I can't get the quality shit, then I'm not going to get it. I'll live without it for now because I want less headaches, man. I don't want to have to deal with headaches. I don't want to go backwards in nitro. I want to progress and go to next level and new heights, man. Like I said, man, I got a lot of big plans, man. I'm going to do shit that you guys have never seen and I've never seen on YouTube. Doesn't mean it's not out there. Just means that somebody hasn't even showed it. Might as well be me. You know what I'm saying? Hey, life ain't easy. You know, eight scale nitro, it ain't easy sometimes, but somebody's got to do it. Might as well be the Muggy, right? So anyway, that's all I got, people. Peace out. I got to get some wrenching to do, put some vehicles back together. I got to get the MBX7, go over it, make sure it's ready and dialed to get out this weekend and do some serious brapping. I'm going to make sure we got a good video, get you some decent footage that I can. So that's another thing I want to work on. Anyway, I'm out, people. Peace. Set your piston, bottom dead center. Put some juice in there. Don't leave the shit up inside the sleeve. Tear up your motor. All right? Peace them out. Got the reds. We're going to tear that apart. We'll do another video later. I want to show you, we're going to take a look together what it looks like inside of a used motor. We're going to see how new it is. I know it's pretty new, but I want to see the inside. So anyway, catch you guys later. Peace.